Now let's look at the kernel itself. Recall that this will look like a serial program that will run on one thread, and the CPU is responsible for launching that program on many parallel threads. This kernel, indeed, looks exactly like a serial program. So here's our kernel right here, this global void square. And so here's the interesting things about this short kernel program. So first, global. This is underscore, underscore, global, underscore, underscore. That's a C language construct called a, quote, declaration specifier, end quote, or for short, DECLSPEC. Don't worry about the name. Just know that this is the way that CUDA knows this code is a kernel as opposed to CPU code. Next we have void. Void just means the kernel doesn't return a value. Instead, it writes the output into the pointer specified in its argument list. This kernel takes two arguments. These are pointers to the output and the input arrays. Recall that both these pointers need to be allocated on the GPU, or else your program will crash spectacularly. Now, note that I name them with d underscore out and d underscore in. That's certainly not foolproof, but if I called it d underscore and I'm consistent about the way I allocate my variables, I know that d underscore variables are allocated on the GPU. Let's walk through the body of the kernel. So the first line of the body here, remember how I said that each thread knows its own index? Here's how we get that index. CUDA has a built-in variable called thread index, thread ID X. And that's going to tell each thread its index within a block. Thread IDX is actually a C struct with three members, .x, .y, and .z. The C struct is called a dim3. We're just using .x in this code, but we'll explain the others a little bit later. Now, we'll launch 64 threads. So for the first instance of those threads, thread IDX.x will return 0. For the second instance, 1. And so on, up to 63 for the last element. Everything else in this kernel just looks like straightforward C. It looks just like a serial program. So what are we actually doing in this kernel? Well, for each thread, we're going to first read the array element corresponding to this thread index from global memory. We're going to store it in this float variable f. We're then going to square f, and we're going to write that value back to global memory in the output array element that corresponds to our thread index.